That's a good question. I try to figure that out every day. I don't know, I'm a worker, you know. I'm in motion all the time. I've been very fortunate in my life because I think when I was very young, I found things that I really love to do and I haven't stopped. Actually, I've been on the road since I was 14, so it's been a long haul. But the thing is that for me, it was very important to love what I do, and I think my work that's continued all my life is really an outgrowth of a long time process. And I work with a lot of very highly creative people, and that really is the storyline, if you would say, of my life. So I'm very fortunate in that regard that I also, as a young person, was surrounded with some great sensibilities. And I think for young people, it is important because it kind of acts as a guide for your life, you know. If you're open to it, there's something to learn and discover every day of your life, whether you're making films or whether you're writing stories or making music or art. You only have to open your eyes. I tell you, I was in the theater for 10 years before I made a film. And the one thing that I loved when I went into the film industry, there was a level of demand and professionalism that was just the criteria to go to work. And I really liked that. There was a tremendous demand made on people. You know, it sounds like a cliche to say that, but I don't take it lightly. Not in this world we're living in now. I would direct film, I suppose, if I found a script that I really was in love with and I felt that I wanted to have all those marriages involved within that script. Because when you take on the idea of being a director, you're involved in many, many relationships to make that work. But I would need a script that I personally love. The documentary work, I've done that all the time. And my interest in getting a camera here is because I am always with a camera. I interview people. It's just curiosity. It's also part of my process. If I want to learn about a subject, I usually go to the subject himself or herself, and I study that person, their behavior, whatever it is they have to offer. But the point is that I really believe that's part of my work. I'm interested in the documentary form, but it's a very slow, arduous process. Tremendous amount of information has to be gathered to make any kind of documentary relevant information. For the viewer, 15 minutes out of 11 hours was enough. Documentary I shot in Kazakhstan, 17-minute film, probably 50 to 80 hours of film. Different images, the government was kind enough to lend me all their archives. I could never have made the film without it. Never could have made that film. But the point is that documentary work is has to be distilled down to the essence of the relevance. You don't have a lot of choices all the time, you know. But right now I've been using a small Sony 4K. But normally, you know, I find it's a matter of taste. As long as you can, it's broadcastable or made, you know, it could be shown in a cinema. It's content and it's the people that you're working with. Everything has to do with what is the information in that frame that is really relevant to the audience. So technology is phenomenal, but content is more phenomenal. And that's the irony of all the technology we have in the world today. But the point is that if you take one camera and you have phenomenal content, it's more important. Romania is a very interesting country for me personally. I find I'm very comfortable with the people. It's just a phenomenon, and I don't know what that is. Maybe it's a work ethic. Maybe it's what they've lived through. Maybe it's the American film industry's cultural influence. But the point is, I find the people very, very open. I've enjoyed my times in Romania immensely. I find it it's absolutely, it's not known to the entire world, and it's a shame. Because it's an amazing culture. when you really take a look at it, and it's a cross section of many cultures, but it's phenomenal to be a guest here always. He's a brilliant young fellow, but he also was the quintessence of what I call Italian neorealism. He was a knee-jerk reaction to his own society. He had an ability to understand one little aspect of a person's behavior could be the downfall of society. You know, one little flaw in a person's behavioral approach to their life could be the end of their life. I'm just the old-fashioned, boring, good guy, I guess. No, I spend a lot of time with my children. I have two daughters, and I'm very much still in their face all the time. And I used to have a lot of animals. I live on a farm still, 35 years. I live very quietly. I must tell you, I treasure quiet and silence, and I love privacy. I'm not the party animal you see on screen, but a lot of people think I am. Relationships. My whole life has been a product of phenomenal relationships. I mean, and I mean that not just in my intimate life, but in all over the world. I mean, the one thing I think that has been, no matter what my career has been, is only a product of incredible relationships. You know, I believe that the world is a strange, you know, being in the film industry is a privilege to be part of this industry. A lot of people don't understand that. It's actually a privilege just to be that. But the point is that, you know, what you learn in this type of work is that we are all interdependent on each other, especially when you have a film crew and you're trying to create a living organism, which is a film, okay? You're all interdependent on each other. And film is like a microcosm of what the world has to finally come to reconcile, which is that we're all only products of these relationships. And our international relationships, our political relationships, the balance of the world lies in our ability to open our eyes to each other and see who we really are. And I think that if we don't do that, it's cataclysmic. But that's our foremost obligation while we're here on this earth. When you say, what is the source of my life, it really, it's all about relationships. I think photography and I think film is an intuitive love. You either love it intuitively or you don't. And I think your love is what information you want to communicate to the world. The only thing I've learned about communication, and I'm slapped in the head every day, reminded of it when I'm in this film industry, is that it must be relevant. And by that I mean it doesn't have to be important. It doesn't have to be intelligent. It doesn't have to be intellectual. It must be relevant. The point is it must in itself communicate. And I think that's the challenge of it, because you can shoot images all day long, but if they don't finally communicate something, then we could look at Facebook all day long or Instagram all day long, but finally, what is it that communicates something between you and I? And I find one of the things I find disappearing, because of the technology world we're living in now, which is moving so fast, digital changed the reality of the film. But the point is that we're not taking enough time to grasp the creative process, that things take time. Information, to develop information takes time. The same way to write a poem takes time. The same way to write a novel takes time. To play a violin concerto takes time. Significant information takes time. It changes the playing field you're on. Because if you do take that time to really make a statement, that information is going to be very, very significant. And the point is, I think for young people today, what's dangerous is to rob themselves, cheat themselves of that creative process. That creative process is your life source. That creative process, that time that you take to gestate, just like an embryo in a womb takes time to develop. That brain takes time to develop. If you cheat yourself of that embryonic stage in life, you cheat the work and it's not going to, you will not sustain yourself. And that's what's dangerous about the world. I find we're moving in with technology. Young people are actually deprived. They're expected to perform instantly. They're expected to know everything instantly. It doesn't happen that way. That's why God gave us education. But the point is, in this business, in the world of entertainment or information or documentaries or even news, you must take the time to understand and comprehend fully and embody your subject. Otherwise, it will tend to be irrelevant. Could be entertaining, but might be highly irrelevant information. And I think that's the one thing I would advise young people today the most. Stay in love with that process. Stay in love with that process. That process will open every door you want in your life. That's what I've come to learn about my own life, is that if you don't stay in that process, you're not learning. You're not learning, you're not discovering. If you're not discovering, then you're not spontaneous, and you're not intrinsically alive.